Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and if you like it, please consider subscribing. So I just wanted to hop in real quickly to share something about this festive season. As you can see from the title, it says, is it really the most wonderful time of the year? So for me myself, I think that Christmas is a beautiful time of the year because you get closer to your family, to your loved ones, and it's just a warm time and moment to celebrate together. But on the other hand, I think that there are a lot of people in the world that aren't happy. For them, it isn't the most wonderful time of the year. And, you know, people who lost loved ones, people who are homeless, people, children without parents, and go on and go on and go on. So I think even though Christmas has become so commercial, you know, people are only thinking about buying presents, one bigger than the other. They're like, people are worrying about the silliest thing, like is the tablecloth ironed, is do I have enough candles in the house or whatever, like all kinds of things. And I think we are forgetting about the real purpose of Christmas. So for me, as a Christian, it's a day to remember the day that Jesus Christ was born. He came into this world so that all of us can have everlasting life. So I think that's one thing that a lot of people forget. And we're like so distracted. We're like so distracted from the real meaning of Christmas. So that's why the title says, is it really the most wonderful time of the year? Because for a lot of people, it isn't. So for me, you know, I like to spend time with my family and remember what Christ has done for me. But I also like to do like more than I normally do. Especially around this time of the year, because of all the people celebrating it together. But there are many people in the world out there that are lonely, that are suffering, whatever. So I just made a small list of things that you can do to make it a wonderful time for everyone. Because we as people, we became like so self-centered, you say it like that? And we are forgetting to serve people, you know? People these days are, not everyone, but a lot of people are like serving themselves and not looking out for one another. You know, the Bible also says, love your brother as yourself, love your neighbor as yourself. Look out for those who are in need, look out for those who are hungry, look out for those look out for those that don't have clothes. So I just made a small list of things that you can do to make it a beautiful time for a few more people than just you and your family. So the first thing that you can do is, if you live in a country that is very cold, you can like wrap, it sounds a bit crazy, but you can just wrap like a jacket around a tree. I saw this passing by, I think on YouTube or something, I can't remember. When you know that there are like living homeless people around a certain area, you can just wrap a tree. You can just wrap a jacket around the tree, and someone who needs it can just take it. Number two, you can find your local charity organization and you can donate food, clothes, or just your time. You know, if they're like organizing like dinners for people who are homeless or people who are lonely, you can do something to help. You know, you can give them your time, your money, your food, your clothes, or whatever. Number three, you can volunteer in a home or, like I said before, in a charity organization. Like I said before, there are a lot of people, a lot of children also, who don't have families, who feel more lonely, especially during and around Christmas time. So you can just find an organization and just ask them, like, I want to do something, I want to help, what can I do? Number four, you can donate money to an organization who does development work. Like here, I've been supporting Doctors Without Borders for many years. And so around Christmas time, they sent me this letter. And you can send, can you see it? Okay, here. Yeah. So they will ask you to like donate something. You can like, or donate a kit for women who are giving birth to a baby, you can donate a special food, you can donate clean water, you can donate first aid, and you can donate a setup for a small hospital, but even more. And I also support another organization who does especially a lot of work in Africa, and they will actually like, if you want to like donate a goat or whatever, you know, like an animal, and if you donate like an animal, you can feed the people, or they will sell it, you know. So there are many ways that you can help organization who does development work by donating money. Another thing that you can do is invite your lonely neighbor for your dinner at home. Just people that you know that are lonely, who lost someone, just invite them into your home and celebrate with them, you know. A lot of people think like, I don't know what to do, or it's too complicated or whatever. You have to think outside of the box and just come with like simple things, you know. It doesn't have to be complicated, and many times it won't even cost you that much, but you will be a blessing for someone else. So those are just a few of these that I came up with, and that I also did myself in the past. Let me know in the comments if you have like other ideas that people can do, so we can all just be take part in it, and just be a blessing for someone else. I hope you like this video. Please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you soon.